Regina en Christopher Catrambone, een miljonairs-echtpaar op Malta, staken hun geld in een schip om vluchtelingen te redden op de Middellandse Zee. Het aantal vluchtelingen dat per boot de overtocht van Noord-Afrika naar Europa waagde, steeg afgelopen jaar tot recordhoogte. Verjaagd door oorlog of armoede stapten ze in levensgevaarlijke bootjes in de hoop in Europa aan te komen en daar een beter leven te vinden. Duizenden overleefden die overtocht niet.
There is a lot of problem there. Fight, even including this Ebola sickness, different kind of between Christian and Muslim. The people that have sense must run away from there because they don't want to die. They are afraid of dying. So those are the reasons why I left. I want to go to Europe to live a good life.
من سوريا واضطرينا نطلع لهون لانه ما حسنا نقعد ولا بلد فيه امان. انا طلعت على لبنان وطلعت على الاردن وطلعت على مصر وبنفس الوقت ولا اي دوله كان فيها الامان المطلوب لانه الي ولعائلتي واضطرينا نطلع للبحر وواجهنا الموت يعني كرمال نعيش حياه افضل.
Afgelopen jaar trok een ongekend hoog aantal migranten vanuit Noord-Afrika naar Europa. Zo'n 207.000 vluchtelingen staken per boot de Middellandse Zee over. Veel van deze mensen komen in de problemen en hebben hulp nodig. Soms worden ze dan naar Malta gebracht. Maar lang niet altijd loopt het goed af. Dit jaar overleefden meer dan 4300 mensen de bootreis niet.
It's very strange because if you can see, they are like a puzzle in these boats. So when you start to unload them in our dinghy, it's like that you break this puzzle. And this, most of them, they have a problem to their legs because they stay 12 hours, 15 hours in the same position, in the same posture, so they can't move their legs.
Regina and Christopher Catrambone. Zij is Italiaans, hij Amerikaans. Ze verdienden miljoenen met verzekeringen. Van dat geld kochten ze een schip, puur en alleen om reddingsoperaties mee uit te voeren. Ze hadden daartoe besloten na de ramp bij het Italiaanse Lampedusa in 2013, waarbij 366 bootvluchtelingen verdronken.
I recall a particular evening that we were sitting at the house and we were watching television and this was after the Pope had been to Lampedusa and how he had talked about the globalization of indifference.
Chi ha pianto per queste persone che erano sulla barca, per le giovani mamme che portavano I loro bambini, per questi uomini che desideravano qualcosa per sostenere le proprie famiglie. Siamo una società che ha dimenticato l'esperienza del piangere, del patire con. La globalizzazione dell'indifferenza ci ha tolto la capacità di piangere.
Looking at our own lives and looking, you know, of how successful that we were, you know, you know, this is our life, you know, and these are people that are struggling to find a new life. At some point, you just decide that, you know, this is what we need to do because we feel that we were called to do this.
De Catrambones richten de stichting MOAS op. En eind augustus van dit jaar beginnen ze met hun missie. Bij de eerste reddingsoperatie komen ze maar net op tijd. Een houten boot is al aan het zinken. Als ze vlakbij zijn, springen de mensen overboord.
And I remember coming back to my cabin and you know, it's just, you know, your adrenaline has been pumping, but then once they were saved, you just had this moment of you know, just tears because it's a very surreal experience to see the desperation in these people's eyes.
Leider van de reddingsoperaties is de Maltese Marco Cauci.
We are here to help you. If you want us to help you, you got to do what I say.
any women and children? So you are all men?
They were so much pain that they were like this. And when we approached them, we said, sit down, sit down. But they said, I cannot sit down. They were taking turns to sit down. The clothes were being soaked with petrol, and it started burning the skin. They had to be treated when we took them on board. They were people dehydrated, but they didn't even have bottles of water, nothing.
Het schip van MOAS ligt nu voor onderhoud in Malta, het eiland waar het miljonairs-echtpaar woont. Het staat bekend om zijn gunstige belastingklimaat en trekt daardoor veel zakenmensen en bedrijven aan. Maar omdat Malta ook op de route van de bootvluchtelingen uit Noord-Afrika ligt, komen die hier de laatste jaren ook vaak terecht. Veelal ongewild.
نحن طلعنا ببارجي وجابونا لهون على مالطا. جيتي لهون كانت كتير صعبة. أغلب العوائل اللي إجت لهون ما كانت جاي هي على مالطا. نحن إجينا إجباري لهون على مالطا. كنا أساس نطلع إيطاليا ومن إيطاليا كل واحد حيطلع شي ألمانيا وشي سويد وشي هولندا. بس هون اضطرينا وهون طلعة ما في.
Nazas wil wel benadrukken dat hij de Maltese dankbaar is dat ze hem hebben gered. Iedereen in het kamp is nog onder de indruk van hoe het hier vlak voor de kust in september nog gruwelijk misging.
The traffickers demanded they change boats several times until the migrants, fearing the vessels were unsafe, rebelled and a confrontation took place. The smugglers then forced a number of people into the water and deliberately rammed the boat and waited in the area until the ship had sunk before leaving. Witnesses say the 300 on the lower deck were trapped and drowned immediately.
Stichting MOAS van Regina en Christopher heeft in 60 dagen meer dan 3000 mensen gered. In eerste instantie vroegen ze de vluchtelingen nog waarom ze aan zo'n risicovolle reis over zee waren begonnen.
I talked to the Assyrian father. He had 3 children with him. And the captain and I, you know, we always talked to all the people on the boats. And we asked him, we said, you know, are you crazy, man? You know, what are you doing? He says, you can't call me crazy because you could never understand what I've had to go through and how it is. And for us, this is our only hope. This is our only chance. And, you know, if you look at their journey of how they've arrived to Libya to make these crossings, every single place that they have come to has been war, has been conflict, has been abuse to them. Until they reach our boat, this is the first contact they have had with people who want to help them.
They are not happy to cross the sea. You understand? Nobody wants to die. They just risk it. If they can survive, let's try it. It's hope. Because they believe that, yes, if the God is with us, we can make it. So that is why people are leaving. Even me, I risk it too.
Van alle Europese lidstaten heeft Malta inmiddels het hoogste aantal asielzoekers per hoofd van de bevolking. Op elke 1000 inwoners zijn er 21 asielaanvragen.
The consequences in having such a high ratio of refugees per capita is primarily that the general public environment can be quite negative. Because Maltese people tend to feel that they've been invaded by refugees trying to reach Europe through Malta.
Neil Velsen is advocaat en staat veel bootvluchtelingen bij.
So basically what you're worried about is that there is no certainty about your future.
Exactly.
Correct?
Yes. Exactly.
Agreed.
Velsen probeert ook de overheid onder druk te zetten het beleid rond migranten aan te passen. Met name het feit dat alle bootvluchtelingen, inclusief kinderen, standaard na aankomst direct in detentie worden genomen. Soms voor enkele weken, soms voor anderhalf jaar.
Physical conditions are extremely bad, to the level that we feel violate the dignity of persons being detained. It has in fact been condemned by the European Court of Human Rights because the conditions have been inhuman and degrading for a number of persons living within the centers.
Nadat de vluchtelingen vrijkomen, komen ze in open centra als deze terecht. Met 8 mannen in een container of met een heel gezin.
مجرد احنا العيشة اللي كنت عامل لك عليها هون العيشة شو فيها شوية هواء شوية امطار شوفي شو صار هون طيب هي اللي احنا طلعنا من موت اجينا لموت ثاني اي شوية هواء بتلاقي الكرفان عملت هيك وهيك اذا بيطلع شوية هواء بتلاقي الكرفان عملت هيك وهيك. بينزل شوية مطر بتلاقي الارض كلها هيك صار فيها المي مو 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 عيشة الاطفال والله العظيم الاطفال بصير لونهم ازرق من البرد هي مو عيشة بنوب أنا باتجاهنا بتمنى أنه تكون بس ما بدنا شيء منهم يأمنوننا بس سكن لبين ما نحسن نعرف البلد نحسن نشتغل نحسن شيء نحن ما بدنا مساعدات دائمة نحن بدنا مساعدات بس ننطلق من أول بس ننطلق أول المشوار بس أكثر من هيك ما بدنا
مالطا is met 400.000 inwoners een klein staatje en zegt de stroombootvluchtelingen daarom niet aan te kunnen. Maar ook de andere landen in Europa doen hun best deze migranten te ontmoedigen om hier naartoe te komen.
If things go as they're going today, refugees will keep on trying to reach the European Union. I think nothing the European Union does will stop refugees. Wars will go on, poverty will remain, people will always flee for safety. It's part of history. It's the way things will happen. I think the most we can do is try to receive them with a bit more dignity and humanity, and maybe try to revisit how we handle refugees.
En terwijl de Italianen hun reddingsoperatie Mare Nostrum aan het afbouwen zijn, neemt de Europese Unie het over. Maar met veel minder middelen en in een veel kleiner gebied.
The other navies in Europe do not see themselves helping in this crisis. And they say, okay, well, this is the Mediterranean's problem, this is Italy's problem, this is Malta's problem, this is Greece's problem, this is Spain's problem, but this isn't our problem. No, it does affect you. It will affect you. It is going to affect you. So why don't you get involved in the search and rescue so that you don't lose your dignity? I mean, I think that that's a big thing is that...
They are losing credibility. If there is a person in your backyard that is dying and you turn your face and say, this is not your problem, which type of humanity you have?
People are afraid, people are scared of being overrun. I can understand that fear, but sometimes I also feel that Europeans have become too comfortable in the luxuries that we have, in the richness that we have. Luxuries that we have worked for centuries to reach this condition. And I think it's only fair that we try to include other people to enjoy the safety we have worked so hard for.
De kosten voor MOAS om een maand op zee levens te redden bedragen 4 ton. Regina en Christopher zijn nu bezig om fondsen te vinden, zodat ze in maart weer verder kunnen met hun reddingsoperaties.